clears the miss. Long hit ahead for O'Connell. Catches, dunks with the right hand. Feed for Baker. Put it on the deck. All the way in. Off the window. Give it to him! For a nice catch. Can't shoot, though. Pull the floor. Looks to the right. Trailer O'Connell for three. Good! And it's down to six. Rebound for Jones. Three on one. O'Connell's on the left. The bounce pass to Moore. Flying in. Reverses it. Up and in for two. Hesitation move, down the lane, swatted out to Moore with one at the buzzer, no. They fight for the rebound, Hurt saves it, and then he's fouled. 11.7 to go, and this crowd erupts as Matthew Hurt pulls the biggest rebound of the night.
I think each guy on the team recognizes that they can be a part of the victory at any time, and they should be prepared for it, whereas when you have a couple, you know, two dominant players or a dominant player, sometimes the other guys say, well, they'll do it or he'll do it. And on this team, they all have to say, I have to do it. And I have to be prepared to do it. So, you know, when guys come up with good games, like, you can't judge what a guy's gonna do based on the one or two games before. And, you know, I'd love to see even more consistency, but I told everyone at the start of this season, it's an old-fashioned team. You know, guys are not gonna be on top of their game every game. It's just, it's very difficult. But if our team overall is, then we're gonna be good. So far, you know, our team has been pretty consistent, and you just have different faces that shine through, with the most dominant face being Trey. Well, that stretch in our schedule where we're on the road, three straight games, and then finish off by having a home game on a Monday, you know, that's a difficult stretch for anybody. And I think during that time, you play in front of about 70,000 people or more. And but to win it at Syracuse in front of 31,000, and they were hot, then to come back and go on the road again and win, and then the game against North Carolina was an epic game. But probably the biggest thing for our team was to beat Florida State after having a week, Saturday through Saturday, three away games, and that emotionally draining game against North Carolina. I thought our guys really showed up the best that they've done the entire season, at a time where human nature would take over for and produce a loss. Trajan Langdon was at the game, he's the GM for the Pelicans, and he said, "Coach, in the NBA, that's a schedule loss, you know." And I'll send a thank you note to the ACC for, after a Saturday night North Carolina game, to have a game on Monday is not the best that they could do.
Jones faces up on Walker. Off of a screen set by Carey. Drives to the right. Cut off there by Vassell. Double team of Walker. Sends it for Stanley. Now to left at Goldwire. Hurt in the left corner. Six to shoot. Hurt into the post at Carey. Four to shoot. Spins up with the left hand. No. Oh my goodness! Stanley to punch it home for two!
You know, people get tired in different ways. You get physically tired. You get mentally tired. But the toughest thing to overcome is if you're emotionally tired. And our team was able to do that, and our bench came through. We needed depth. Florida State tries to punish you with their depth, and our depth won. You know, our bench outscored theirs 21-13, and two of the kids that really came up with great performances. One was Javon Delorier, because you could tell that Vernon was not at the top of his game for that game. And Javon came in and, you know, six defensive rebounds and really protected our basket. And then Alex O'Connell, after a timeout with about 8:30 left in the game, he came up with five straight points that gave us a spark. And you know, that's how we've been winning. It's not just the guys who have started games, but it's our bench.
Right, some strengths I see with this team is definitely our depth to start off with it being a long season and being in the conference that we are in with all these tough games. Just the depth that we have, and we're able to go to different guys on different nights, just depending on who's playing better than other guys that night, who has it going, who's hitting their shot that night. Just the depth that we have, being able to look down the bench, or sometimes it's in the starters, it's different every single night, but the depth that we have, and we're able to just roll guys in at the other team.
Yeah, we change, we look different depending on who's on the court. So it's not like you're running the same offense. Hopefully, we're doing the same things defensively. And that's where we gain our identity. But our team really does want to win, and I think it shows up in the last 8 minutes of a game, 8 to 10 minutes of a game. And we haven't been able to start games with the verve that I would want, you know. But we did against Florida State. But we finished games where, you know, Joey Baker or Alex O'Connell, you know, come and do, you know, something really good. Jack White, and obviously Trey Jones has been a master.
Yeah, the will to win on this team is unmatched, I feel like. I mean, it goes hand in hand with our depth. I feel like everyone who comes into the game wants to win and is trying to help in any way to win. And so when things aren't going right, we're trying to find the right group to be out there that is going to get things going in the right way to win. But I mean, everyone on the team wants to win and is trying to do everything they can for the team to help us win.
Inside Basketball with Duke's Coach K is brought to you by Coca-Cola. Taste the feeling. By Reed's Jewelers, a proud partner of Duke Athletics. And by Gatorade. Win from within.
Gatorade Zero. All the electrolytes, zero sugar.
Level 3, huh? I have to start.
All day, baby.
NBA champion?
Boom, and I really care what my bump into. Bulldozer, make room. Write that pun for the tune. Wish they all had my leg room. Another deal, it ain't even noon. Tour Dior, or sit by the pool. I can do.
Hey!
Nah, we not like that.
Gatorade Zero. Get more out of zero.
Continental Tires are built for the road that connects you to all of life's journeys. And for nearly 150 years, we've been developing tires to fit your needs. Each Continental Tire is designed to give you precise handling and traction in all seasons. And a quiet, comfortable ride wherever the road takes you. You're at your best when you're doing what you really love. We're at ours when we're helping you get there. Continental Tire. For what you do.
Get 0 for 72 or get $11,500 in total savings on select F-150s. Only at your Carolina Ford dealer.
Down by five, 54 seconds to go. Stanley for Jones looking to drive. all the way to the rim to lay it in for two. 21 seconds to go, Duke down by four. Here's Jones all the way to the hoop, put it off the left window, all the way around it in, and Mike Krzyzewski's going to take a timeout. Jones. This is it. Long rebound to Hurt. Now Jones. Jones with one. Jones puts it up at the buzzer. Yes! He ties the game! And we're going to overtime!
There was a moment you took over this game. 15 straight points at one point for you, Trey. What was going through your mind as you took over?
Tyus Stones. He's been in the same moment before. He did greater things than that, so. Shout out Big Bro. I know he's watching back home or wherever he is right now. I'm just trying to be like Big Bro.
Outside, Tyus Jones goes to the rack, up off the rack, good. Head of the way, can't. Now goes in the paint, collision. Shots up, good, and a foul called on the blood. At the top of the circle. Sees a little opening. Garsh down the left side, goes all the way to the left, can't count it. Tyus Jones, nobody came over to stop him, and it's tied at 81.
84 apiece as we start overtime. Jones down the left side of the lane for the lead off the left window. Jones on Anthony, cross him over, got inside, pull up jumper. Oh, he's feeling it. Duke down by five, 20.9 to go. Trey Jones has it, driving down the center of the floor, looking to drive on Keeling, forced it up and in, and a chance for three as Keeling fouled him. On the way, no, long rebound, tapped out, controlled by Goldwire. Jones with three, with two for the win, no, tapped up by Moore, and in at the buzzer! Moore makes it in, and the Blue Devils win it, 98-96. Trey Jones and Mike Krzyzewski embrace, and it's a Duke Blue kind of night in Chapel Hill.
Goes out of bounds. Nope. Corralled by Jones. Ahead it goes to Cook. In the air. Hanger off the glass. Count it. 3-point line. Now backs Meeks down. Meeks has got four fouls. He up and unders him and gets the basket.
Left-hander puts it up and it's short and it's rebounded up in the air. Tie up. Duke's got the ball. Tyus Jones comes up with it. They got the win. 92-90 over North Carolina. To go 23-3, 10-3 on the year in the Atlantic Coast Conference. But what a finish here in Camden Indoor Stadium tonight.
Well, Trey had against North Carolina, you know, he was driving our bus, let's put it that way. We were in his moment. You know, I mean, obviously it says, you know, a win for Duke, but he basically had one of those rare, unique, amazing performances that sometimes a player has. And I think it helped him, too, that his buddy Jordan Goldwire, we were able to, when Trey was scoring so much, and then he still had to guard Cole Anthony, yeah, we realized, you know, he's not going to be able to do both those things. But we need him to really score for us. And we put Jordan on Cole. And whatever, it saved a little bit of gas, let's put it that way. And really, we did the same thing against Florida State with Forrest, who's, you know, one of the really outstanding players and defensive players in the country. And that worked. So he had more energy at the end, and we could do that without taking him out of the game, but putting him on a different guy. And because Jordan's played so well, especially on the defensive end, that's a rare commodity to have.
Jones in transition down the center of the lane, floats with the right hand for two. Jones at the left elbow, ends that. Goldwire slowly working his way to the left, finds Jones. Jones a driving lane at the free throw line, jumper up and in. Jones a little stutter step dribble off the left window for two. Tend to shoot, Jones up top, shakes the shoulders, gets inside, off the left window and in.
I mean, what's different for me from last year to this year in ACC play would be just knowing the entire intensity it's going to be every single night, no matter who we're facing, no matter whether it's in Cameron or it's on the road, someone else's home gym. We got to bring the same energy every single night because we know that, or I know that, every team is coming out and coming for us, no matter who we're playing. So just trying to be up and ready for every team, knowing that they're going to give us their best shot, and we got to bring it every single night.
Meanwhile, Jones in transition, dribbled it off his left foot, somehow got it back. Jones into the paint, spinning by traffic to lay it in for two. Some cosmetic work to do before the Blue Devils pick up their 16th win of the season. It starts with a Jones steal and a chance to run and a lay-in on the left side.
Just trying to follow my instinct to try to be a leader as much as I can be. Having a good communication with Coach. He's always telling me to talk to guys, to speak up, speak what's on my mind and what I see out there on the court, or whether it's in film, something I see from our team, whatever it is. I'm trying to speak up more, but just having more of a voice throughout the entire team, throughout the entire game, practice, whatever it is.
The next level for us is voice leadership. We need more, not leadership by example. We always want that, but we need leadership through command, through voice. And when you become an outstanding leader, you're able to do both of those things. And yeah, if Trey can do that at a high level, then our whole team will get better because our guys ultimately respect Trey, and they should.
Definitely something I'm still learning how to do is be more of a vocal leader. I feel like my leadership has come from just leading by example, but as I came here, coaches continue to push me every single day to be more of a vocal leader, lead with my voice more, and help everyone out as much as I can with my voice.
Major auto accident. Let's do what we do.
Serious injuries. Clearly our driver's fault.
So what's the plan? Delay? Deny?
What? They called the law offices of James Scott Farron.
I think you should handle this one.
If you've been injured in an accident, tell them you mean business. Call on the Hurt Line, the law offices of James Scott Farron, right now.
No, you handle it. No, I insist. You handle it.
Even a bad day fishing's better than a good day working.
Yeah.
They multiply what they love, so we multiply the cash. Multiply the cash up to 50 times with new Multiply the Cash scratch-offs.
Let's talk about math. Fuel points math. For every dollar you spend at Harris Teeter, you get a fuel point. 100 fuel points equals 10 cents off per gallon. 200 fuel points equals 20 cents off per gallon. 1,000 fuel points equals $1 off per gallon on quality fuel. And if you're shopping at Harris Teeter with your Vic card, your fuel points are already adding up. Check the bottom of your receipt. Harris Teeter Fuel Points, an easy way to save on fuel.
See harristeeter.com for details.
Point of Attack with Chris Patola, presented by Continental Tire. For what you do.
Under out of bounds plays are such a big part of the game of basketball. It's almost the special teams of basketball. And it's an opportunity that you're at a set dead ball, an opportunity to set up a play. And Coach K has always been so good with under out of bounds. And he does a lot of their stuff out of this 1-4 set, you can have your four guys down here on the baseline, or in this particular play we want to show you from the Miami game, he had the four guys across the foul line raised here. So you've got Cassius Stanley, Vernon Carey, Matthew Hurt, Jordan Goldwire, and here's Trey Jones taking the ball out underneath. And this is where the defenders were at the start of the play. So you've got Cassius, this guy on the weak side, who's kind of sucked in here on this weak side. You've got these two guys defending like this. Jordan's guy was hugged up here because he's on the strong side, which is the side of the basketball. Now, Coach K has run this particular play for his great athletes going back decades. He's run this play for Grant Hill. He's run this play for Jason Williams. And he's run this play for Gerald Henderson. And he's run this play now for Cassius Stanley. And it seems simple, but it helps to have a good athlete. These guys are going to basically cross. So Matthew's going to come down here. Vernon Carey's going to cross in here. And what it does is it catches the eye of the defense. So the defenders have to suck in with these guys. And Cassius's guy actually sucks in on the movement of Matthew coming this way. So what does that do? It takes all of these guys and puts them all down here on the baseline. And what you have is a wide open lane for Cassius Stanley to come down the middle. You get a good lob pass right here, and you get an unbelievable finish from a guy who could finish well above the rim. Great execution, great design, under out of bounds, Cassius Stanley with the flush.
Jones to inbound, lob it to Stanley! Puts that thing down with the right hand!
Years with Coach K, presented by Vivid Seats, official partner of the Duke Blue Devils. Don't get just any seat, get a Vivid Seat.
Yeah, you know, it's an amazing honor to have the court named after me, and I'm glad they didn't put the whole name. You know, it would have to lengthen the court, or you wouldn't see the court. You'd just see print. But tremendous honor. I mean, because I understand the history very well of this great program and this venue, named after Eddie Cameron, who was a giant, literally a giant. I love that. You know, our stadium is named after someone who accomplished, not someone who gave money. And I wish everything would always be like that, especially sports-wise, because what more can a person give than his best? And Eddie Cameron did that, and then that's what I'm trying to do as the coach here, and to be have my name with his is pretty incredible.
Hell yeah! Hampton Farms peanuts, roasted with delicious flavor inside the shell. Available in salted, unsalted, and Cajun hot in the produce section of a grocery store near you.
Why do I do what I do? Why do I give so much to helping total strangers? Why do I care so much about it?
Yeah.
At Duke Health, we are committed to discovering, developing, and delivering the future of healthcare. The extraordinary is what we do every day, but why we do it is much bigger. I'm Megan, and you're why.
When we're born, we're more alike than we are different. Then somewhere along the way, we start to believe the more distant we are from each other, the more different we are. It's only when we venture into the world that we see all we share. Maybe that's the power of flight. Delta isn't flying just to bring us together, but to show we were never that far apart.
It's time.
It's time.
It's time.
It's time. Okay.
Think ahead. Think advance. Get free testing and installation with batteries starting at $79.99 at Advance Auto Parts.
Hell yeah!
Hampton Farms peanuts, roasted with delicious flavor inside the shell. Available in salted, unsalted, and Cajun hot in the produce section of a grocery store near you.
Luger forgot the basketball. He's out near midcourt trying to get by Goldwire. No luck. Goldwire knocked it loose, but it came to Durham. And now a steal. Goldwire has it. Headed in. Lay it up and in. Durham spun right by him to elevate and rock the rim. The rebound tapped out, control by Jones. Jones two on three, pulls from three. Bang! Bounces it inside for Durham, goes up on Carey, slide it out of there. Jones in transition, three ball up, too strong. Hurt gets the long rebound back to Jones. Now to Goldwire to lay it in for two. To the baseline, Pfluger, blocked by O'Connell. Coming from behind, and now Hurt saves it. Jones in transition. Bet O'Connell, three ball, give it to him. Jogo trying to drive, taken away by O'Connell. One on one to the rim, lay it up and in. Into the post, stolen by Baker. Jones headed the other way, feed it to Baker. Three ball, bang!
You know, we've played 24 games, and our guys should have a little bit more maturity now going into, not that they have been immature, but they're young, and they're still developing. But, you know, you learn by being in experiences, and when they're winning experiences, your confidence builds. What we have to do is make sure that we look at things the same way we've been looking at them all year. You know, one game at a time. And don't be concerned about where you're ranked, what's your league, you know, where you are in the league. All those things. Those are intermittent stops. They're not the final destination. You know, what is the destination is each game. And, you know, try to be consistently excellent, and everything will work out. If we do it that way. And so far, especially since Christmas break, this team has done that. So we're not going to change that.